I play a mom, and my little daughter is about 8 or 9 years old, and she's very sick. So part of what I need is to get out of this mess where all these awful things are happening. And so I have a kind of intense panic that when they quarantine the house, it isn't just like, oh my God, we can't leave the house. It's, oh my God, my daughter's dying. So there's got an intensity to what my path is. But basically the movie is about, you know, people who are discovering that crazy things are ensuing and there's horror all around and none of us are allowed to leave. That's have no contact with the outside world.
Okay, how do you keep up that level of intensity?
You know, I love the athletic part of being an actor, and I loved the idea that we would rehearse, instead of in a normal movie where you have a tiny scene and they do coverage of it, they would rehearse something for a long time. It was a long scene, like a play, and then they would just shoot it and just say go. And so what I loved is that the intensity starts building as time goes on, and so you're in the middle of a scene, you forget you're an actor. You kind of forget that you're dealing with something kind of phony, and in the end of it, there's nothing phony about it at all. You're kind of caught up in the fear, and when the body drops down, you literally have a moment where you think the body has just dropped down.
I would think that's an exhausting process.
It's kind of exhilarating. I mean, I'm not a person that's seen a lot of horror films, but after this, I got thrilled about doing another one, and I ended up doing another one, actually.
What did you do next?
I think it was actually backwards. I did The Haunting of Molly Hartley, which is coming out in 2 weeks, and then I did this one after that. And then someone said, my God, if you keep going on the horror film genre, you may not stop. So I have taken a little bit of a rest and work on a sitcom and have done that for a while. So.
Nice. So, but before this, you didn't really do horror movies.
No.
I wonder, so you got hooked
there was something
quickly.
Going on in my life that... you know, I don't know what it was. I did have a baby, and something, you'd think that after you have a child, you wouldn't want to go the horror path, but I did have a cesarean, and a lot of blood came out. So perhaps I became connected to blood as a result of motherhood. Who knows?
Why should people go see this?
You know, I think a lot of horror has an exhilarating ride that you don't necessarily kind of buy. You can always sort of go distant to it. This one, I believe, has an amount of truth to it that I think will carry the audience to a place of such extraordinary fear that why not push yourself to a place where you go, oh my God, is it real or is it not? So I'd go see this to actually live that kind of fear. If you like haunted houses, you like scary things, go see something that is actually going to take you to the edge like this.